afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Hell Show, and today is Friday, and we are settled down in Austin a little bit here for the last couple days. Anne-Marie and I went out to an improv show last night that was really cool. We finally had an opportunity to spend some time together, just the two of us, and do something fun. But today, what we're going to do is we're going to wrap up the week with some more Dr. J.E. Williams. I know you guys are enjoying this. Today's going to be talking about the Chinese medicine view of raw foods. So you might want to be interested in this. You might be interested in this, so check it out. So this is an interesting question. It's about Chinese medicine, because you study Chinese medicine. And I know that you eat a lot of raw foods, but the Chinese medicine approach has a different viewpoint on raw foods. You want to explain that a little bit?
It's not just Chinese medicine, Kevin. It's Chinese culture. So you have a Chinese civilization, and it goes back several thousands of years. So here you have traditional Chinese, which would be most Chinese in China, and the Chinese communities outside of that. We have more than a billion people who eat absolutely no raw foods. No meaning zero. And they believe that raw foods are dangerous, and they're difficult to digest, and that cooked foods are the civilized approach to health. So here I have a culture of, including monks and Shaolin monks and so forth, who are all eating cooked foods, and they're super healthy and extraordinarily dynamic individuals, and they're not overweight or not underweight. So, Chinese medicine, though, has several interesting things I think that are very important for people, is that foods are not enough. So there's traditional Chinese culture, very big on herbs, and they include herbs in their cooking all of the time. They start with soups that are made from vegetables and meats and seaweeds and seashells and all different types of things. And herbs are always included in, including ginseng, the goji berries that they call it. It's totally pronounced incorrectly. The biggest distributor of organic goji berries was visiting me several years ago, and he was saying, "Well, Dr. Williams, we've got goji," and I have no idea what you're talking about. And he goes, "Yes, you do. And, you're a famous Chinese medicine guy, And honestly, I have no clue. I have no idea." I said, "Oh yeah, you." I said, tell me the Chinese name. He said, "That's the Chinese name." I said, "No, that's not the Chinese. You don't have the characters of Chinese." "No, of course not." I said, "So how about the Latin name?" "I have no idea. We just imported, and it's huge." I don't know how I missed that. And he said, "I'm sure you know." He said, "I'm going to send you." So a few weeks later, I get a whole case of a very common red little berry. It's in the current family, Gao Ji Zi. Changed to Goji.
Right. Mm-hmm. Say it again slowly.
Gao Ji Zi. So every Chinese family knows, we might call them kitchen herbs, including Gao Ji Zi and Deng Kui, and probably 12 to 20. That they'll use in their cooking on a regular daily basis. And then they use spices in their herbs, and they spices in their cooking, not Western spices, but Chinese, related spices. And I think that, we need to also use more herbs and more spices. So in my gardens, I'm always growing fresh herbs and spices. I'm always adding things in. You make a stew or a soup, and then I'm putting fresh garnishing at the top. They have trace minerals that you can't get from other vegetables. They have other very important sources of life-giving factors that they're absolutely essential. So I think in terms of raw foods people, that's one of the things that they really miss. They lack adding those herbs in. Very, very essential. And also for the cooked foods people.
You have to cook some of the herbs, though, too.
Oh, absolutely.
In order for them to be potent.
Yeah, you have to cook the herbs.
All right, well, after watching that and after, you know, hearing the Great Health Debate and all this sort of stuff, you know, you can definitely tell that there are a lot of different opinions on what we should eat. What do you think of the Chinese medicine approach when it comes to eating foods? I know a lot of you guys are into raw foods or high raw, so myself included, so, you know, I have some opinions on it as well. But tell us what you think. Go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Have a great weekend. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.